फर्स्ट ड्रग इज द अकेसिया गम, राइट, और अकेसिया अराबिका. सो अकेसिया गम इट इज दी वन ऑफ द मेडिसिनल प्लांट विच विल बी हैविंग दी कार्बोहाइड्रेट कंटेंट इन मोर क्वांटिटी. दैट्स वॉट दिस कम्स अंडर द कार्बोहाइड्रेट कंटेनिंग क्रूड ड्रग, राइट. सो लेट अस डिस्कस द फार्माकोग्नोस्टिकल डिटेल्स अबाउट द अकेसिया गम. सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द डिफरेंट सिनोनियम्स, वॉट आर द डिफरेंट नेम्स वी कैन सी हियर. सो यू कैन सी द इन इन पिक्चर दिस अकेसिया द प्लांट हाउ इट लुक्स लाइक सर. यू कैन सी द लीव्स, यू माइट बी सीइंग दिस प्लांट, राइट, येलो लाइक फ्लावर, हेयर लाइक फ्लावर इट इज गोइंग टू हैव, राइट. एंड इफ देर विल बी द इनसीजन, दिस काइंड ऑफ गम्स इट इज गोइंग टू सीक्रेट आउट एंड इट विल गेट सॉलिडिफाई ऑन टू द सर्फेस ऑफ द ब्रांचेस एंड द स्टेम ऑल्सो. सो वंस इफ यू कलेक्ट दीज गम्स, राइट, दे विल बी लाइक दिस द डिफरेंट इरेगुलर टीयर्स, राउंड शेप टीयर्स लाइक क्रीम वाइट ब्राउन टाइप्स ऑफ टीयर्स वी कैन सी, राइट. सो दिस गम वी विल बी हैविंग द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सैकेराइड्स, दैट्स वॉट इट इज कार्बोहाइड्रेट कंटेनिंग क्रूड ड्रग. सो लेट अस डिस्कस द सिनोनियम्स. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट इट, देर इज 11 टाइप्स ऑफ सिनोनियम्स विच विल बी नोन इन द डिफरेंट एरियाज. इट इज अकेसिया गम, अकेसिया वेरा, राइट, like aloe vera will be there, no, so like that acacia vera, like that you can remember. So here the Egyptian throne thorn, right, then the gummy africanum, then gum senegal, guma mimosa, khair, it is also known as khair, sudan gum arabic because of, right, somali gum, येलो थोर्न एंड इंडियन गम और गम अराबिक, राइट. सो इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज इंडियन गम सिंस इट इज अवेलेबल इन इंडिया. सो यू कैन रिमेंबर दिस एज पर योर कन्वीनियंट, लाइक द ड्रग स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ए, राइट, अकेसिया गम एंड अकेसिया वेरा, देन इजिप्सियन थोर्न, ए बी सी डी ई, देन ई एफ जी, जी फ्रॉम गमी अफ्रीकैनम, गम सेनेगल, गम माइमोसा, लाइक दैट. So you can arrange in this way or as per your convenient, but if you will try to give the maximum synonyms which is known as used for the acacia gum, right? So like that you can give. Coming to the biological source, second important sub points under the pharmacognostical detail of acacia gum, according to the USP, acacia is the dried gummy exudation obtained from the stems and branches of Acacia senegal wild, right, wild means forest, or other African species of Acacia also we can get it, right. So in India, because you have seen in the Indian gum also, right, so in India it is found as a dried gummy exudation obtained from the stem and branches of Acacia arabica wild, belongs to the family Leguminosae, right. So both are Leguminosae family only, but the species name, it is Arabica, means India, Senegal, right. So it is different one. So like that in Africa and all those regions, like that we can identify. So Acacia Arabica wild, that is the Indian one, right, that you can write. Coming to the geographical source, means where it is available, which agroclimatic requirement it is suitable for that particular. Let us discuss. Acacia senegal is the characteristic species in the drier parts of Anglo-Egyptian Sudan and the northern Sahara. Sahara Marusthal, you know, desert, northern Sahara, and is to be found throughout the vast area from Senegal to the Red Sea and to the eastern India also, right. So you can see here almost the Senegal, Sahara, Egyptian Sudan, right, eastern India, Red Sea, from Senegal to Red Sea. So these are the area where this Acacia senegal, it is going to be cultivated, or it can grow at that agroclimatic requirement. इट एक्सटेंड्स साउथवर्ड्स टू नॉर्थन नाइजीरिया ऑल्सो, उगांडा, राइट, नाइजीरिया, उगांडा, केन्या, देन टेंजानिया, साउथर्न अफ्रीका. सो दिस नेम ऑफ द कंट्री यू शुड रिमेंबर व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग द जियोग्राफिकल सोर्स ऑफ अकेसिया. द प्लांट इज एक्सटेंसिवली फाउंड इन अरबिया, देन कॉडफैन, दैट नॉर्थ ईस्ट अफ्रीका एंड श्रीलंका एंड मोरक्को ऑल्सो, राइट. इन इंडिया इट इज फाउंड चीफली इन पंजाब स्टेट, राजस्थान एंड वेस्टर्न घाट ऑफ हिमालय, राइट. सूडान इज द मेजर प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ दिस गम एंड द कैटर्स ऑफ अबाउट 85% ऑफ वर्ल्ड सप्लाई. मीन्स इन सूडान, दैट्स वॉट दिस कंट्री, इट इज 85% ऑफ द टोटल प्रोडक्शन ओनली इन सूडान इट इज गोइंग टू. दैट्स वॉट इट इज, सूडान इज नोन एज द मेजर प्रोड्यूसर. सो बेसिकली यू शुड रिमेंबर दिस मेन नेम ऑफ द कंट्रीज लाइक नाइजेरिया, उगांडा, केन्या, टेंजानिया, मोरक्को, श्रीलंका, इजिप्ट, ईस्टर्न इंडिया, लाइक दैट, राइट. देन सूडान यू शुड डेफिनेटली यू शुड मेंशन इन योर जियोग्राफिकल सोर्स आंसर. कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट वन, कल्टिवेशन एंड कलेक्शन. हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कल्टिवेट अकेसिया अराबिका व्हेन इट इज फॉर द कल्टिवेशन. अराबी अकेसिया इज अ थॉर्नी ट्री अप टू 6 मीटर इन हाइट. हाउ मच हाइट? 6 मीटर. मीन्स यू कैन इमेजिन इट्स ऑलमोस्ट वन ऑफ द ट्री, राइट. इन सूडान गम इज टैप्ड, राइट, टैपिंग, यू नो द टैप्ड फ्रॉम स्पेशली कल्टिवेटेड ट्रीज. While in Senegambia, because of extreme of the climate, cracks are produced on the tree and the gum exude and is collected from the wild plants or wild grown plants, the plants which is already grown into the forest. From there, they are the this particular gum, it is collected by tapping method, okay. Acacia tree can be cultivated by showing the seeds in the poor exhausted soil containing no minerals, remember, right, which containing no minerals not required. The trees also grow such as by seed dispersal, right. So that's what the propagation which is done by the showing the seeds. So it is coming under the seed propagation method of cultivation, okay. The gum is collected. Ultimately, why we are cultivating this plant? To collect the gum. So gum is collected by natives from 6 to 8 year old tree, right. We need to wait up to 6 to 8 years that tree will become old, then only it is going to exhaust more gum. And the collection, it is twice a year in dry weather, right. Two times we can collect, we can make the collection. And it should be dry weather, because in wet weather or in rainy season it is going to wet, and you are not able to collect because it will fall down into the ground in November or in February to March, that month also given which is suitable for the collection of gum. Natives cut the lower thorny branches, the branches, to facilitate the working, and by means of an axe make 2 to 3 feet long and 2 to 3 inch board incision. You remember, incision, we have to make the incision onto the branches, on the stem and the branches, right. Then loosen the bark by X and remove it, right. We have to loose the bark, right. We have to by the X and we have to remove it so that the gummy material can come out and it will get solidified. Taking care not to injure the cambium and the xylem, because if you will do so, if you will injure the cambium, the plant may die and they are not going to survive further. That's what the incision should be made in a such a way so that the cambium and xylem will be safe, and at the same time they will be removed from the X and they will be able to exhort the gummy material which we are going to collect later on. Usually the leaves, they leave the thin layer of the bark on xylem. If xylem is exposed, white ant enter the plant and the gum is not produced. So this is the drawback, right? That's what xylem should not be exposed, because the gum, the production of the gum, it depend on to the xylem. This white ant, they are going to interfere. After injury in winter, gum exudes from after 6 to 8 weeks, while in summer after 3 to 4 weeks. That is the time duration difference between the season. In winter, it is taking 6 to 8 weeks, whereas it in summer, 3 to 4 weeks. It is believed that bacteria finding their way through the in-season are more active in summer, and the gum is produced quickly. That, see, what is the reason behind it? Whatever the bacteria which is participating into the gummosis process or the production of gum inside, they are finding their way through the in-season and more active in summer. This you should remember. That's what in summer it is taking only 3 to 4 weeks. The exuded gum is scraped off, collected in a leather bags, and then is cleaned by separating debris of bark and wood, and separating sand particles also by sieving method. And we have to remove all the unwanted material which has been mixed during the scraping and during the collection of the gum. Gum is dried in sun by keeping in the in trays, right? In thin layer for about 3 weeks, when the bleaching takes place and it become whiter. That's what in starting we have shown you, right? Before it will be in different. So when once if the drying process will complete, it will become whiter. This result in uneven the contraction and the cracks and the fissures are formed on their outer surface. And as a result, original transparent gum become opaque. And this process is called ripening of the gum, right? So some changes occurs during this process. The cracks and fissures are formed. So that will become like this. Coming to the morphology, how the appearance it is going to have. If you see the color, tears are usually white, pale yellow, and sometimes creamish brown to red in color. The powder has off white, pale yellow, and a light brown in appearance. Whereas odor or the particular aroma, it is odorless, doesn't have any odor. Taste is bland and mucilaginous. If you will chew into the cut into the teeth, and if you chew it, you will get the mucilaginous taste. Shape and size, tears are mostly spheroidal or ovoid in shape and having a diameter of about 2.5 to 3.0 centimeters. If you see the appearance looking, the tears are invariably obvious, either due to the presence of cracks and fissures produced on their outer surface during the process of ripening. The fractures are usually very brittle in nature, and the exposed surface appear to be glossy. Chemical constants, very, very important. That's what we are studying here. What are the chemicals are there in acacia gum? Acacia consists principally arabine, which is a complex mixture of calcium, magnesium, and potassium salts of arabic acid, right? So this arabine you should not forget. You should remember arabine, principally of arabine, right? Arabic acid is a branched polysaccharide that yield L-arabinose, D-galactose, D-glucuronic acid, and L-rhamnose on hydrolysis, right? So this arabic acid, if it will undergo hydrolysis, these are the polysaccharides they are going to yield. 1,3 linked D-galactopyranose unit from the backbone chain of the molecule, and the terminal residue of the 1,6 linked side chain are primarily uronic acids. Acacia contain 12 to 15% of water and several alkylated enzymes such as oxidase, peroxidase, pectinase, etc. The total S content should be in range of 2.7 to 4.0%. That much S content supposed to be have. Chemical test or identification test, how we are going to identify the given sample of gum is acacia only. The first test, lead acetate test. In this test, aqueous solution we have to prepare up acacia and treat with the lead acetate. So heavy white PPT you are going to get. That is the positive test for lead acetate. Coming to the second test, reducing sugar test. Hydrolysis of aqueous solution of acacia with dilute HCl, it yield reducing sugar. And whose solution is to give a brick red PPT of cuprous oxide, right? So that is the indication. Presence are ascertained by the boiling with failing solution. Coming to the third one, blue coloration due to enzyme. How it is going to give? If you treat the aqueous solution of acacia with benzidine in alcohol together with a few drop of hydrogen peroxide H2O2, it gives rise to distinct blue color due to the presence of oxidase enzyme. The fourth test which we can perform, that is the borax test. An aqueous solution of acacia offers a stiff translucent mass on treatment with the borax. So that is the indication, stiff translucent mass, right? A specific test only for acacia, the 10% of aqueous solution of acacia fails to produce any precipitate with dilute solution of lead acetate that we have discussed in first test, right? A clear distinctions from agar and tragacan, okay? It doesn't give any color changes with iodine solution. That is the specific test. A marked distinction from the starch and dextrin. And it never produced a bluish black color with FeCl3 solution because of a apparent distinction from tannin. So these are the specific tests we can perform for the acacia gum. What are the different uses of acacia? The mucilage of acacia is employed as a demulcent. Right, it is used extensively as a vital pharmaceutical add, right, for emulsification and to serve as a thickening agent. It finds its enormous application as a binding agent for tablets, right? It is used as a binding agent for the tablet manufacturing. It is a binder, good binder, for example. In cough lozenges also it is going to be used, right? So we can see here in most of the pharmaceutical preparation acacia is going to be useful. It is used in the process of granulation, see, for the manufacturing of tablets, right? Granulation process acacia is going to be useful since it is binding agent. It is considered to be a gum of choice by virtue of the fact that it is quite compatible with other plant hydrochloroids as well as starch, carbohydrates and proteins, right? So gum of choice, most of the gums or gummy materials which we are making for to stick the different articles. So acacia, it is going to be more useful by the different industries like Fevicol, Fevikwik, or many things are there. So they are going to use this one. It is used in the combination with gelatin to form the conservates for microencapsulation of the drug, right? Whenever the drug content should be encapsulated in the microparticles, at that time also, these gummy materials are used with the combination with the gelatin so that it can be encapsulate the particular drug content into the micro particles, and it can be used for the further. It is employed as a colloidal stabilizer, right? It is also colloidal stabilizer. It is used extensively in making of candy and other food products. Candy and food products also, acacia is going to be useful. Gum acacia solution has consistency similar to the blood and is administered intravenously in hemodialysis. It is used in manufacture of adhesive and ink, and it is used as a binding medium of marbling colors, for the marbling colors, right? So you can see here acacia is having a lot of use, not only into the pharmaceutical field, but also in other industry also. At the same time, it is having its medicinal values also, right? So this is the first drug we discussed from the carbohydrates. So that you need to refer this pharmacognostical details of acacia, right? Apart from